Hello students, welcome to our class. We are studying now fiber to fabric chapter 3 in science. In this we have studied about types of fibers, natural fibers, synthetic fibers. Natural fibers we take cotton and jute or plant fibers, and animal fibers are obtained from sheep, goat and camel. Cotton is collected from the hairy seeds of cotton plant. From that we can get the cotton fabric. Next we are going to study about jute, which is called as the golden fiber. In India it is the second most famous fiber. Among the world, India is the largest producer of jute. Jute is produced from the stem and outer skin of the jute plant. Jute is very durable, strong, but it is very rough. So people don't prefer for clothes, but we can make bed sheets, carpets and bags. Jute seed is sown during monsoon in warm weather. It grows about 8 to 10 feet height. Jute fiber harvested in West Bengal and Assam in India. We get the fiber from the stem of the plant. Next one is retting. After reaping, harvested stems are dried and tied into bunches. The bunches are sunk into stagnant pond water. During this time, the stems get rot, and a gummy substance holding jute fiber together gets destroyed. This process is called retting. So in the jute fiber we are having the gummy substance. So when you sunk it in the pond water, it will be destroyed. And jute fibers are separated from stem using hands because it is very strong. After separating the fibers, are dried in sun for 2 to 3 days. Then the fibers are tied as bundles. Then the bundles sent to the jute factories. In jute factories, the fibers are weaved into yarn. The yarns are made as fabrics in the factories. After that, the fabrics are used for many purposes. So from the jute we can get many articles like jute bag and jute mat and jute carpet. You can see in this picture, from the jute yarn we can get the jute bag, jute carpet, jute mat, and also strong rope. It's very strong, so we can prepare rope also. Next, wool. It is obtained from the fleece of sheep. And wool is also obtained from camel, yak, alpaca and other animals. So these animals have a layer of thick hair around its body. So the major steps in processing of making wool is shearing, cleaning and scouring, grading and shorting, curling, spinning, weaving and finishing. Next, silk. We get silk from the silkworm. The silkworm feeds on the leaves of the mulberry plant. It gives out a long sticky thread from its mouth. This thread is wrapped all around its body and becomes the home of the silkworm. You can see in this picture. The home of the silkworm is called the cocoon. The threads from the cocoon are woven to make silk cloth. Silk cloth is very soft. We know that. Next, synthetic fibers. As we have studied, synthetic fibers are manufactured by technological innovations or chemical treatments by human beings. Polyester, nylon, acrylic are some of the types of synthetic fibers. Properties of synthetic fibers, we take. They are durable, less expensive, readily available, easy to maintain, and synthetic fibers dry up quickly. Because of this character, we can wear the synthetic clothes. There are some disadvantages in synthetic fibers. Synthetic fibers melt before burning. Some electrical charge accumulates on the synthetic fibers. The electrical charge causes irritation of the skin. Extremely hazardous to the environment. It can make our body overheat. It can make cold when wet. And the difference between natural and synthetic fibers. Synthetic fibers completely man-made. Natural fibers are come from nature. Natural fibers have length in nature. In synthetic, we man-made length. Natural fibers chapel of filament. Synthetic fibers filament sometimes converted to staples. Natural fibers, we don't have spinning process. Synthetic fibers, we are having spinning process. And natural fibers need scoring and bleaching. And in synthetic fibers, very few scoring and bleaching. Natural fibers easy to dye. And synthetic fibers not easy to dye. If you burn natural fibers, we can get the ash. But synthetic fibers melt after burning. Synthetic fibers have chemical smell after burning. Natural fibers have smell of the hair. These are the main difference between natural and synthetic fibers. We can have one activity depending upon the weaving process. So you can do it in your home, paper weaving. For this, you need two color papers. One paper you take and you fold the paper. Cut the paper in the folded area till the edge. And after that, you can get a paper like this. This is called as loom. Considered as loom. And we can take a stripe of paper in different color. You can insert the paper in the loom over, down, over, down, over, down. You can take second stripe and opposite to the first stripe, you have to insert it. You can get like this. And in the third stripe, you can take as first stripe. And after that, you have to paste the edges. Till the end, you have to insert the strips, different color strips. After finishing that, you can get a paper mat like this. So you can use this paper mat and it is an activity for you. You can do in your home. Thank you.